I have been a prepper since the 80s. When I heard George Bush Sr. give a speech and use the words New World Order, I got up out of my chair and said, oh my God. From that moment on, I became a prepper. I always had a backpack in my car prepared for who knows what. I don't even know. I just know I had the mentality of it. I have buckets of things that are buried in different places that are for emergencies. Obviously, we would want some food in here. This is what's called an MRE, the military meals ready to eat. Now, you have other things that you can put away. This is not just a head net for bugs. I could get little fish with these. I mean, there's many things you can do with that.
Let me try that on.
All right, now the bugs will stay away. So if something is only used for one thing, it's taking up space. To me, the most important thing that you need is this right here, which is a water filter. I remember in Katrina, there was plenty of water, but it was not drinkable. Is there anything else you can think of we might want?
A knife.
How smart are you?
Pretty damn smart.
I'm telling you, you are learning. You're a quick study.
Okay. Excellent. Well, shall I put
and
the lid on?
And then we just screw the lid on.
And you keep some of these things somewhere?
Yes.
And where have you put them?
Not in the house. I have them in a safe place.
That you alone know?
Yes.
Your attitude towards prepness is, I'm prepared as far as I can be.
Yes.
For most eventualities.
Yes. It's my responsibility to take care of me, not the government's. And if it doesn't happen, so what? But what if it does? Are you prepared?
I wouldn't last 5 minutes. And, you know, I haven't got a prepared attitude. I've got some money in the bank and 12 rolls of loo paper at home. And that's
not even enough.
That's the extent of my prepness. I have a slightly fatalistic attitude that I'll just either get by or I'll die.